Right, okay. Hi, camera two. How you doing? I am Paul Murphy. And this is an electric version of Where the Rainbow Ends. Those of you who watch my channel assiduously, pardon me, I just have to pick my jeans up. I'm wearing leg braces to stop me falling over because my leg paralysis. Oh, you cannot imagine what it's like. Imagine having about 16 porcupines strapped to your legs. Doesn't feel like this, I just want you to imagine it. So, if you watch my channel regularly, then you'll know two things. One, that I never start straight away, so you always got to wade through all this stuff here. I only know the 30 seconds, guys. But if I'm doing something acoustically, I bang on for like an hour. I use all these weird open tunings and everything. And no, not yet, not yet. Millifractured rhythm. But when I'm playing electrically, I just stick it on. I'm tuning an electric guitar in 20 years, you know? Because I just like that kind of sound. Anyway, so here's an electric version of Where the Rainbow Ends, a song written by me and Emily J. Murphy and Dylan Tempest Murphy about them missing their friends in lockdown. 2, 3, 4! The tempo, okay. It's too clean a sound, I don't want any dirt here. I love you. your input. They want that more than I can say. Every day, I love you. Urban Paranoia. So now you closed your goodnight eyes, whispered your instructions. You let your lovers taste the cavemen, blood of their destruction. While in the town that you call home, your parents own a hovel. They
When you drive by your limousine and you smile and see the grovel, the baby says she got a break for some guy who take a photo. But he doesn't have her studio. He says, why don't you meet me at a motel? She needs to be the star so bad. She tells you it's her destiny. So she does some favors for the boys and says, maybe they'll invest in me. All the guys, they smell all the same. So she learns to turn her nose off, and all their promises smell the same. Soon as she takes her clothes off, the airport shut because the runway froze. Or so the TV said. Oh, and Johnny No One just jumped on the roof with a Bible on his head. His mama swears that she's in shock, and the pappy's so distressed. Then they're on the Late Late Show, and the checks are signed the press. They never would have amounted to much. Nobody would have heard their story. So they take the fame while it's there, but Johnny lost the glory. And the preacher had a dream last night where an angel gave salvation. And the sergeant caught a glimpse of hell. A fire bombed their station. They meet together at the docks and swap the consequences. For 30 years they kept the faith. Now damn all the pretenses. And the candidate comes calling wild his young wife and the surgeons. Oh, you gotta look good on prime time. When you shout, let's bomb some turbines. These skeletons are a PR train before they leave the closet. You'll sleep with that new engine tonight. And tomorrow, say, who was it? The magazine's most perfect waste. The girls with eating problems who choked to death on diet pills, and the company says what of them, and the banks all get a crushing storm for their high executive mothers who closed down the nursery school next door. There's one law for the others. The dealers selling bad advice make fortunes from bad hunches, and they spread upon the homeless on their way to their business lunches. Conscience, they don't apply no more. Traded it in for a luxury life. They get you that mansion by the lake and the right connection. Why? When did you last call up home or wonder where your friends are? Or did something good for anyone without asking what the ends are? The world outside is getting dim. The loud is turning grey, and the razor blade you wanna win has stripped your faith away. The shy guy in the boarding house cuts the glossies into pieces. He knows the pastry girl is him, and each day his rage increases. The blonde girl in the flat below, he knows it's her, but is it? Maybe next time she's all alone, he'll pay her a little visit. And Jenny, she still gets those dreams each time she shuts her eyes. She can't forget what stepdaddy did, no matter how she tries. And mommy didn't want to know, she just said she was lying. Now stepdaddy's at the door again, and he loves it when she's crying. Someone's knocking at the door. Let's pretend that we're not home. It's not, I'm paranoid. But please leave me alone. I know you'll only smile at me. Pounce and do your worst. I know you'll wanna kill me, so I just have to kill you first.